YouTube, Itch with the Franchise Guy. Come back at you again with another episode of NHL 19 Franchise Mode featuring Philadelphia Flyers. I mean, we're at the trade deadline right now. I think we're like 2 days before the trade deadline technically, but we're at the trade deadline. And this is our team going forward. This is our team currently. Jakub Voracek, Connor McDavid, Claude Giroux. First line, golden. Second line, gets a little dicey. Taylor Lear, Sean Couturier, Nolan Patrick. These two are great. These are both first-round draft picks. Taylor Lear has the all-time record for most Flyers game or most Phantoms games played. I would prefer him to be on the third line with Frost and Kasha be on the fourth line. So we are looking for a second-line left winger. So we have Lear, Frost, and Carter. I've noticed also that Voracek and Carter have started to regress. Voracek started the season off as a 91. He's an 89 now. Jeff Carter, less drastic. Went from an 81 to an 80. Again, not a big deal. But Frost, Abe Kubel, and Nick Suzuki. Suzuki, honestly, probably needs to go back down to the minors. 62 games, 18 points, 2 penalty minutes, plus minus negative 3. Yeah, he's a minor scoring forward. So he needs to go back down to the minors. Kubel can go down to this line. I'm fine with that because he's a 79 and he's earned it. He's got, what, 26 points? That's perfect for a fourth liner. So I'll be looking for a third line right winger and a second line left winger. Hopefully I can find them. I mean, we do have some players in the minors that are willing to trade. Liston's not for trade. Ratcliffe, Suzuki, Ronning, not for trade. He was a project. He might be up for trade if they need him. Strome, possibly. Say the defense, maybe Palmquist, the Haas, or I mean, these guys, I'm fine getting rid of them. I mean, we just drafted some pretty decent studs for the minors. Even I think one of our starting defensemen, I think we have scratch defensemen that are down here. So, scratched. We have Brandon Manning down here, as well as Austin Zarink, Francis Perron, and Evan Cormier. He's a goalie. I'm not entirely sure why we have him. But these three guys right here are definitely up for trade. Yeah, they're not going to improve much more. He's definitely not going to improve. Perron, maybe he'll go up a little bit, and maybe in a little bit I should think of, but I don't know. Brandon Manning, though, probably is going to be the replacement for Radko Gudas as our seventh defenseman. So Gudas is up for trade. Same with Warwick Carrier, also up for trade. Because we have Jordan Wheel, and we don't need Warwick if we have Jordan Wheel. So yeah, a bunch of trades going down. Hopefully I didn't miss anyone. Definitely going to be trying to trade for draft picks for those extra guys that we have. Get them off the books for salary-wise. I did scout around for some players. Ottawa. I didn't realize Ottawa had Brayden Schenn. Only an 81 overall, though. Not about the best. $7 million for an 80 overall. For 6 more years. Oh, boy. They are... And they still have Duchesne on contract for 5. Oh, they're going to be in one cap problem real quick. And Thomas Chabot for $6 million for 5 years. I think it was them. Alex Formanton, left winger, 83 overall. He's listed as a third line check forward, but I think 20 points though. Second round draft pick sniper. I feel like he can go in pretty well on our second line overall wise, because he's going to go in with Couturier and Patrick. He's just going to be an upgrade over what we already have there. I mean, he's going to be an upgrade over Lear. Not the greatest upgrade, but he's going to be an upgrade. Lear's under contract for 2 more years. Same with Kasha. I mean, by next year, we're also going to have Dmitry Lyssen come up. So Lyssen will definitely replace Kasha on the team. Strom has no trade value either. So good luck with us trying to trade Strom. Dawson Cox. You have a bunch of left wingers that are coming up real quick. I mean, even someone like Artem Vasanov, I might even consider trading. Just because I know we're going to have Lyssen next year. He's listed as a top six. He's definitely going to be, on our top three lines next year. Made top four. I don't know. Let's go with Cox. All right. And let's go to defenseman. I mean, ETF 54. Let's see, trade rejected. All right, do I want to do this? So yeah, they're not gonna trade him. That's unfortunate. I don't want both of them. Nope, just Cox's interest. All right, so back to trying to find the left winger. An affordable left right, because they only have like $2 million left in cap, so that's gonna be the real problem. I mean, I would tell you something like max something about $5 million. It's gonna be really hard to move that much cap right there. Forsberg, I mean, oh man, it's just, oh boy, there's a lot of problems cap wise we had. Kiefer Bellows, I mean, they're not in a playoff spot. They're below 500. So, you guys willing to talk for Kiefer? Oh, wrong one. So, Kiefer's like right there. So, let's throw in Vasanov. Let's throw in Cox. This Cox is the same age, lower overall. Defenseman they want. I mean, top four. I guess 2.5 off the books. I would definitely hurt our top six though, because our top six is already very weak. Let's try with Orton. And just to get his contract off the books, let's go Rodko Gudas. Let's trade Rodko Gudas again. It's definitely in your favor. Draft picks. Edmonton, New Jersey. Let's give you Arizona's fourth, or Arizona's third. Now, why does no one want to trade their young players? I want to trade young players who are easily cost-controlled. So I have a second-line left winger. Oh man, the AI sometimes is not fun. Boris. I mean, I'm not entirely sure about Boris here. I don't really like Boris. He's on a 2-year deal. I just don't want anyone on that. Andres Palat. On an expiring contract. Andres Janssen. Let's see. So Giannis is on an expiring contract. Cox, 4-10. They want Gudas, they want the third. Vegas. You're not gonna trade Payne Krebs. You're not gonna trade Pex. I'm not gonna take Pacioretty off you. Alright. Any third line right wingers? Alex Tuck. I mean, Tuck, 24. 2 year, 25. 2 years left at 2-7. Fairly decent trade value. I mean, you don't have any. Where's Dale Weiss end up down here in the AHL? Way to go, Dale. There's 1.5 cap it. Riley Smith. Oh boy, Ovi would not be a bad left winger to get, but I guarantee you I'm not going to afford getting him. Gage Doan. Right winger, Tom Wilson. Shoots right, unfortunately. Frana shoots left, but not going to be able to afford that $4 million. Year. Zuccarello, maybe? Nah, Zuccarello shoots left. Not a big upgrade, though. Not big enough, the one that I'm willing to fork over for a one overall difference. Line A, I'm not going to get. Ehlers, I'm not going to get. Like Wheeler, not gonna be able to get. Oh boy. Semenov, Kasha, Corey Perry, Ryan Hartman, current Flyer, 2-way forward, only 78 overall, unfortunately. Doesn't really help us out. Nick Ritchie. Oh boy, who thought upgrading a team to trade that would be so hard? Who thought teams wouldn't want to trade away players? Or who thought every team in the league would be in a playoff hunt with players on really expensive salaries? Pasternak's 20. The Pasternak's only 25. Wow. Alright, maybe I think about the differently. Maybe I go. Alexander Nylander. Brian Hart. Pozo. Patrick Bergelin? That is. Justin Bailey. Alright. Foot. Sundin. Marcus Johnson. 4 years though, not taking a 4 year contract for Marcus Johnson. Calgary. Alright. Oh boy, who really did think that this was gonna be the start of an episode? 15 minutes in, and I've actually yet to make a trade. James Neal at 5 million, not gonna take him. Silverberg, 3 years, not gonna risk it. 3 years for Silverberg. I mean, it's a mix of either they don't have talent to trade for. Like Calgary right here. Or I just can't afford it. Like, there's no way I could afford, like, Patrick Kane. Or Ty Ratty. 29. I mean, upgrades our top 9. It does technically upgrade our top 9. Gets Nick Suzuki out of the top 9. Their top 4 lines, or top 12, really. 9.5 cap hit. Let's try. Oh, wrong button. This one to sort. Jordan Wheel. I mean, they want, Chartier. And they're gonna be over salary cap. They rejected. Of course, trade rejected. Oh boy. Alright. New plan. Let's find someone who wants everyone. Just trade them off. Fire sale them. Let's try. Fifth for Gudas. Trade accepted. There we go. Alright. An extra fifth right here. We have 3 fifth round draft picks. Alright. Goalies. Any extra goalies? See, all of our problem is all of our high-end talent we've traded away already. So, I mean, we could definitely trade away players like Dimitri right here. At 20 years old, 65, I'm not too worried about him, you know, blowing up. But McElroy down here, 1977, I mean, you know, I'm not the worst. I'm not too entirely worried about trading away him as a prospect. Panthers are definitely interested in him. Not any left wingers? Any right wingers? Evgeny Dadonov. 3 years at 4.8. Alright, the Habs. Right wingers, no right wingers. Left wingers. Lafreniere. Teravainen. Let's just try this. Let's see if I can somehow stack this box so high where I can draft picks. I will give you New Jersey second for this year. I will give you San Jose's third's worst. All these fifths are the same. It's a good second right there. give you New Jersey second for next year. And again, I'll stack this box right there. I'll throw him on my second line right there. He will grow exponentially, and I will reap the benefits of him for 3 years. Not gonna trade McElroy though. Lear, Kasha. Interested in him, I'll toss in him. Who else are you interested in? No, alright, that didn't help me one bit. Alright. Lear running. No, alright. And trade rejected. What about? Hear me out. I give you not Edmonton. I'll give you Edmonton second for this year. Edmonton second for this year. New Jersey's for next year. Our 2025 second. No, I'm gonna keep that second. Oh, come on. Come on, don't freeze on me now. There we go. I'll give you 2027 first round draft pick. Let's try. Let's remove this fifth round. Throw in. Our 2026 first round. So two first round draft picks. Edmonton second for this year. Trade rejected. Come on. You know you want this trade. You've told me you wanted this trade. Alright. There's a defenseman you wanted. Which defenseman do you want? You want him. Trade rejected. The value is not off. The value is way in your favor. Oh boy. Who thought trading would be so hard? I guess anyone who is trying to trade for someone's top prospects. Alright. New Jersey, you're interested in him. Left wingers. Taylor Hall. Brett. He has a 2-year extension on him. At 23. Now let's see. Now we might have a deal going. Draft picks. Wanna give me your first rounder for this year? rejected. All right. How about your first rounder for next year? And a... Let's take Washington second. Trade rejected. All right. No second. Trade rejected. Oh, come on. Capitals first round draft pick. And your 2024 draft pick. But it's definitely in your favor. Trade rejected still. Come on. Don't be doing this to me. Don't be locking me out. Nope. I want a second, not a third. Second. Second. Yeah. Still in your favor. Trade accepted. There we go. Jesper Bratt's on the team. That's what I like to see. That's an upgrade to our left. All right. Let's take a look. Let's reorganize the lines real quick. Only took us 26 minutes to get a trade done. Which I like to see. Paul Carey, you'll be sitting on the bench. Jesper Bratt will be moved into our second line. I mean, 37 points opposed to Lear at 25. And Kasha, even Kasha's doing better. Jesus. Yeah, let's do it like that. Let's put Kasha up here, because Kasha's doing better on the third line. Kasha's having a really good year. Now let's upgrade this right side to send Suzuki back down. Defense remains the same. Just make sure I didn't train anyone I forgot about. Chet here. All these extra guys I'm going to look to move to, just to get them off. Let's get something out of them. Proposed trade. Look at that. First trade's off. First trade's done. We're the first big trade of the offseason. Or the on-season. Whatchamacallit. Right wingers. Alright. Top nine right wingers. Richie... I mean, I do like Ryan Hartman. He is a Flyer currently. In the AHL right now. It says a fourth liner, 27. I'm going to skip out on him. Brett Ritchie. Brett Ritchie's intriguing. Let's see, what's your point total? I could just do it from the screen. Nah, not really for that point total. Top nine. Craig Smith. 29 points. Alright. I'm not gonna find anyone there. Some of these contracts are really bad. Look, I got Pozo's contract. $6 million, two more years. That's a bad contract. Elias Lindholm. Not be a bad person to take home. That 4-8 though, definitely. Nope, not what I wanted. Not what I wanted. 44 points, not the worst. Mezzi. Carolina. Frankov. 21. Definitely on a 5-year long contract. No. Hard pass. Pitlick. Blackhawks. again. Tyratty. Oh boy. Timothy Ferguson. Oh boy, that's Colorado. Look at you. 90 overall at 21. You are doing great for yourself, Colorado. Who's on this team? Rantanen. Oh, that first line is stacked. And Tyson Yost and Hugo Lemieux. Hugo Lemieux is okay. I don't need... That first line is stacked, though, right there. That's probably the best first lines I've actually ever seen in this game. Hands down, one of the best first lines I've ever seen in this game. Zykov? No. Top 9. Radulov. That's 6 million cap that I cannot afford you, Radulov. I am sorry. Or could I afford Radulov? I can somehow afford Radulov. Top 9 forward. 1 year left. I mean, he's instantly coming off the books. As soon as the season's over, he's off the books. What's his trade value like? Not the worst trade value. Oh, Skaters, who are you interested in? How are you interested in Gossespierre? Interested in Drew, but not Gossespierre. Weird. Brat, they're interested. That's always funny. Carter, I mean, I feel like Jeff Carter is part of the reason why we're held back on some things contract-wise. Just because Carter has a big contract. He is, I think, our worst contract, technically. I don't think I have any trade assets for Radulov. At least I'm not willing to give up. Ryan Suzuki, already better than his brother. Look, Nick Suzuki, 22, 76 overall. Ryan Suzuki, 20, 77, gonna be on the team next year. I think Nick Suzuki we should be probably looking to get rid of, actually, very soon, because his trade value is not going to get much better. Oh, boy. Can I do... He deals in our favor currently. Trying to get a draft pick involved. The third project. All right, deals in our favor, or their favor. Let me get a fourth project. Come on. All right, let me get a fifth for next year. Come on, trade project. Really, straight up. Trade rejected, really? You're not gonna give me Radulov for... Not understanding that one bit. And one Vashinov at all? Artem Vashinov going once? Going twice? No, no tickets for Artem Vashinov. We did acquire a first round pick for next year. Always a good thing. Goalies. I'm all scared. Let's just move those players. We're going on 35 minutes. We're just going to move those players now. Alright. person. Manning's coming up. Perone. Anyone interested in Czarnik? No. San Jose, you have some cap room. Out of fifth. Favorite rejected. Alright. I expected that one, really. How about a sixth? Favorite rejected. Oh, okay. How about a seventh? There we go. Trade accepted. Alright. Back to all skaters. Sort y'all one more time. Alright. See someone I'm trading? Yes. St. Louis, Tampa, Toronto, Vancouver, Vegas. Alright, Vegas. Let's do a deal. Can I get Anaheim 6th for it? No, disapproved? Why? There's that one of 45 skaters. Okay. Washington. Let's make a deal. We get a 6th for this year. Trade accepted. Part of the deal right there. I think he's only one more player with the trade. Ryan Suzuki, Vashinov, Corso Wrigley. We drafted him, right. Perron, that's who it is. Who's got cap space? Yotes. Let's make a deal. Alright, you have one broken board this year. Oh boy. Let's get a fifth. No, I haven't had more than 50 players. Alright, which team could honestly really care less? 39-17? Let's go to them. That's probably why they want to trade Radulov. Hey, how about a fourth? Or Perron? Trade accepted. Way to go. Alright. If you guys like this episode, I don't know why you would, because this is actually a really boring episode. I thought we'd do a lot better trading-wise. Make sure you hit the like button down below. Links in the description for the rest of the playlist. I mean, I promise all the episodes aren't this boring and tedious and almost 40 minutes long. Sorry about that. But yeah, if you guys like this episode, make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. If you guys missed the episode, check the playlist down below. Peace out. Rock on, YouTube.